Would you mind if I asked who you are and how you got here? From just looking at you, I'd say you look kind of human. How did a human get to this realm? Oh, let me guess. Did you, like, do a lot of drugs or something? No? Weird. How did you... Oh, this isn't the first Zodiac domain you've been in, is it? Oh, no. Okay. What other Zodiacs have you visited? Oh, that's quite a few. Interesting. So, and you don't know how you came to be here. Perhaps this is part of your life path then. Do you know who I am? Yes, good guess, I suppose. I'm Libra. Yes, you know, the star sign. You've heard of me. That's good. Am I not what you expected? You know, you'd be surprised. Some of the other Zodiacs are surprised by my style sometimes, too. They think, why is Libra so dark and gothic looking when in the past, you know? She's supposed to be, like, pink and, I don't know. I guess they want me to be a certain way, and I'm not. A lot of people assume things about me, you know, that I should be doing things a certain way or act like how they think I should act, but really, I enjoy walking the line between light and darkness. I mean, my whole thing is about equilibrium, so why would I limit myself to only one style? Yes, my domain is rather dark and murky, but there are few who are willing to spend time in the dark the way I do. Yes, it's interesting, isn't it, that you are curious, but smell still unfazed. Do you find my home beautiful? Or kind of scary, or a healthy mix of both. Well, that's good, I guess. Now, what do you think brings you here? Have you been having a hard time finding balance and harmony in your life? Usually when I get the errant traveler or explorer, they're having trouble with certain aspects of their life, specifically with balance, justice. Is there something in your life you feel is unjust? Most of it. That makes sense. Now, I'd like you to relax a little bit. Let the darkness hold you. It's not as scary as a lot of people think. Without darkness, how can there be light? You know, it's about both of those things. I have plenty of things I could teach you, but no traveler really stays for long. You understand? Yes, the nature of these realms is that they are fleeting, and organic life can only stay here so long. But you, you're an astral, aren't you? Yes, you don't appear to be in a physical form. You're just taking the appearance of it because it's comforting to you. It's all you own. That makes much more sense. Because this domain can only support certain kinds of organic life. Specifically, fungi and certain plants. But here, in this realm, we walk the line between life and death. So while you're here, you're kind of in both. I sometimes do work as a psychopomp. That's someone who crosses over souls. But I leave that mostly to the bigwigs. It's just this zodiac is a form of my consciousness, and the consciousness of the other signs takes many forms. And you think we just limit ourselves to one thing in this vast universe that goes on forever and continuously expands? Which thing seems more practical to you? In that case, change or stagnation? That's why I don't understand when humans are always talking about how change scares them. Which is understandable, but you have to know it's coming eventually. It's a part of existing. If everything stayed the same all the time, what would the point be? It stays the same until you're comfortable and used to it, and you've learned what you're here to learn. Then it changes so that you can learn the next thing. Now, speaking of learning, I have all sorts of little tidbits in here. What sort of thing were you hoping for me to shed light on? You've been having trouble clearly with maintaining balance. Do you find yourself afraid often? Or just temporarily? Every now and then? I'm so sorry you're going through that, but it is an important part of life. You are interested in the darkness, yet you fear it. Why do you fear it? Have you been taught to fear what you don't know? That might be something worth looking into. What influences have you had in your life that have made you so afraid? And what exactly is it that you're afraid of? Do you often think of things in terms of, well, black and white? Or do you allow that speck of color in every now and then? You know, colors exist in the spectrum between black and white. They can be useful tools to help you open your eyes and see the beauty that comes with the world between. It's important to recognize that, to find the beauty in the things that scare you. Beauty and terror often go hand in hand. They are two sides of the same coin. Someone finds something beautiful, while another person finds it scary. It all depends on perspective. You could say that what makes things change and not change all depends on perspective and one's willingness to allow things to happen. These are all important things for you to note. Do you have an interest in magic? By magic, I just mean being in tune with your surroundings and seeking to understand that which previously is thought to be ununderstandable. I don't know if that's a word, but we're going with it. Or did you come here just to chat? Make friends? Get to know the different signs and what they stand for? I wonder what God set you forth on this journey. You're clearly going through some self-discovery stuff. Don't be ashamed. That's perfectly normal. In fact, I may have incarnated as human once or twice. And let me tell you, that shit is rough. But in my personal journey, I found it very necessary. Especially because I love helping people understand, you know, understand things that they are scared to or don't know. I think you are one of those people who is braver than they think they are. You'd be surprised what you're capable of handling. And the universe won't put you in a situation that things you can't handle. If you find yourself in that situation, think about the things that have brought you there. Was it really the universe? Or was it bad choices? Or the bad choices of others? Food for thought. Now, would you like some tea? I specifically made this in case of guests. I do this pretty much every day, helping someone might stop by, and usually I get the errant soul every now and then. Someone recently deceased, scared and confused, and I help them sort through their problems. This tea has a really strange taste. I'm just going to take a look. Yes, as I thought. Stuck in there. Oh, how did that happen? Perhaps my sanitary practices need work, but this is a little skeleton finger. I've been actually looking for this for quite a while. You see, it's the missing piece to my crystal ball. Yes, I'll show you since we have time. Yes, you see how it's missing a finger. It creates this problem where, well, first of all, this thing is shattered and old, but it creates this problem where the magic spell is incomplete and I can't exactly read. Perhaps this needs some serious medical work. Some bone connector. Would you like me to look inside? Perhaps another time. It seems our time together is coming to a close. You feel tired, don't you? Exhausted. You've been interplanar traveling for a while, I see. And you still have a few more to go, don't you? Well, I hope our time together has been beneficial for you. And if you'd like to stay here a little longer, you're welcome to. I can find a lovely bed of moss and mushrooms for you too.